craniotomy and phacoemulsification in angle closure glaucoma. So we all know that trabeculectomy is not free from complications. Trabeculectomy has problems pertaining to hypotony, there will be choroidal effusions, cataractogenesis, bleb related problems, there will be bleb leaks, endophthalmitis, and the trabeculectomy has not changed over the last 100 years. So we have to look for alternatives to manage the IOP in our patients. So this study was conducted to evaluate the intraocular pressure lowering efficacy and safety of goniotomy with phacoemulsification in mild, moderate and advanced stages of primary angle closure glaucoma. It was a prospective interventional case series. So we enrolled consecutive patients with PACG who had either high IOPs or borderline IOPs or IOPs which was controlled on medications, and they were taken up for phacoemulsification. The postoperative change in number of medications and IOP was analyzed over a 12-month period. Success was defined as IOP less than or equal to 18 millimeter mercury with or without medications. Phacoemulsification was proceeded with. Intraoperative gonioscopy was performed in which microscope was tilted towards the patient and the head of the patient was tilted away from the surgeon. So this is how.
Audio visual, please see this presentation is not getting through.
So the head of the microscope was tilted towards the patient's head and the head was tilted away from the surgeon to enable maximum visualization of the nasal angle, followed with Swan-Jacob lens was put up by the assistant and a nasal angle was visualized, otomy and phacoemulsification in angle closure glaucoma. We all know that trabeculectomy is not free from complications. The procedure itself has unchanged over the last 100 years and we all of us encounter problems with trabeculectomy pertaining to hypotony, bleb related complications, more need of secondary interventions, etc. And therefore there is a need to look for alternative procedures in such cases. So the study was conducted to evaluate the intraocular pressure lowering efficacy and safety of goniotomy performed with phacoemulsification in all stages of primary angle closure glaucoma. It was a prospective interventional case series and we enrolled consecutive patients with PACG who had either high IOP or borderline IOP or IOP which was controlled on medications and who were to undergo phacoemulsification for this study, and change in number of medications and IOP over a 12-month period was analyzed. Success was defined as IOP less than or equal to 18 millimeter mercury with or without medication. So this is a video of a patient who underwent phacoemulsification. See, we can see that he has an anterior chamber which is shallow, a bulky nucleus, and a routine phacoemulsification is proceeded with. After we put the IOL in the bag, we constrict the pupil with intracameral pilocarpine to enable maximum visualization of the angle. And then we proceed towards intraoperative gonioscopy. In this, we tilt the microscope towards the head of the patient. And the head is tilted away from the surgeon because we are doing the goniotomy in the nasal angle, and it helps enhance the visualization of the nasal angle that way. Assistant holds the Swan-Jacob lens here. And we can see some goniosynchiae are present, which are being lysed with the help of a Helon cannula, which is a 26-gauge cannula. Following goniosynchiolysis, we then proceed towards goniotomy. And using a single bay disposable MVR, incisional goniotomy is performed here. And the high magnification, we look at the pigmented portion of the trabecular meshwork and we incise the angle in clockwise direction and then in the anti-clockwise direction. With both the ports we do it and we can achieve up to 120 to 180 degrees of angle incision depending on the visibility. Hyphema is very common complication, and following the goniotomy, we aspirate the blood that has been there, and in the end, we tamponade with air to prevent any bleeding reflux again postoperatively. So in our study, we found that the mean age of the patient was 58 years. They had a high IOP of mean of 27 millimeter mercury. On an average follow of 13 months, 15 eyes required goniosynchiolysis in these cases, and the other did not require. Mean treated angle was 130 degrees and 16 patients were on 4 or more medications in this group. 63% patients had severe or advanced glaucoma. We found that there was a mean decrease in IOP from the baseline of 23 to 13 millimeter mercury till 12 months of follow-up, which was noticed. That was 37% reduction in IOP. And two eyes did not achieve IOP control and required trabeculectomy during the course. Also, there was a difference in the hypotensive medication. It decreased from a mean of 3.1 medications to 1.2 over a period of postoperatively, which was maintained till 1 year. This is a number showing that 21 eyes required either 0 or 1 medication at follow-up. The others, only 2 eyes required 4 medications, which was also seen preoperatively. This is an ASOCT of a representative patient, where we can see that initially the AC was shallow and angle was occludable. Later on, the AC is deepened and the cleft can be seen in the nasal angle. With ITC index has improved 35% from the initial 95% in this patient. Kaplan-Meier survival curves showed that the absolute success rate without medications, extra medication, was 5.4% at 1 year, but with qualified success with medications was 94%. When the target IOP was 18 millimeter mercury, with the target IOP of 14 millimeter mercury, the qualified success rate was 49%, which was quite satisfactory. Complications that we observed was hyphema. It was observed in 13 eyes, of which 3 required anterior chamber wash postoperatively. One of them recurred, but it settled on its own. And some eyes, 3 eyes developed PCO formation, which was sealed till 6 months and required a YAG cap. And one eye had IOP spike, which required anti-glaucoma medications immediately postoperatively. Other than that, no major complications were seen. In the published literature, Kahok dual blade has been used in early and moderate initially it was used in POAG patients. Then the studies came for severe and refractory glaucomas. And there is one latest paper on primary angle closure glaucoma. It is a retrospective study, 6 months with Kahok dual blade. However, in India, Kahok dual blade is not available to us. And therefore, MDR as a sustainable procedure, single use disposable, is a very good option. And we have seen with MDR significant and sustained reduction in IOP in our cases, with significant decrease in the number of anti-glaucoma medications also sustained till 12 months. So it is a safe and effective method. Minimal complications are there. And by IOP stabilization, goniotomy can defer filter in these advanced glaucoma by a few years. However, filter still remains a viable option in eyes with severe peripheral anterior synechiae, which is not amenable to goniosynechialysis. Thank you.